So let's start with a little bit of the history of coreboot. So version 1 was created in 1999, as I said, Linux BIOS created by Ron Minich. That time he worked in Los Alamos laboratory. The goal was to boot Linux as fast as possible, and if possible to put Linux inside spy flash when normally BIOS was placed. So he tried to replace BIOS with Linux. This project was called Linux BIOS, and it was mainly operated in version 1, mainly operated in 1999 and 2000. Then we have another stage of Linux BIOS back then and future coreboot, 2000 to 2005. Then we started to gain some additional support for various architectures, x86, Alpha, PowerPC, and then there was there were some problems with projects like the memory initialization caused some significant issues because the memory technology rise in complexity. Because of that, ROMCC project was created to change C into stackless assembly, and ROMCC kind of compiled C code in a way that it used registers for storing values as a stack. Then there was the device tree concept introduced back in the days, probably even before Linux device tree concept. Then first payloads were introduced to make booting more flexible. In this period of time, there was big contribution from various vendors, from Intel, a lot of contribution and open source, AGISA from AMD, VIA, SIS. There were many components contributing to that project back in the days. Then we had another stage. We can call it version 2 plus. It was 2005 to 2008, where there was introduction of cache as RAM, AMD 64 port, ACPI and SMM support was added. There was flash on project created, which helped in flashing Linux BIOS binaries or coreboot binaries. Free Software Foundation was interested in coreboot and started use Linux BIOS coreboot on their own servers. In version 3, 2006, 2008, there was more than 100 mainboards supported, but version 3 was kind of experiment where some things were tried, for example CBFS, just to so it was like a wrong path of evolution, or path of evolution that gave some ideas which were moved forward, but the V3 branch was killed. They get back to V2 and ported some most important improvements to V2 and then progress to V4. In 2008, Linux BIOS was renamed to coreboot. There was also change of the maintainer back then. Ron kind of give place for Stefan Reinauer. In V4, from 2009 to 2012, they moved from SVN to Git. There was also big contribution from AMD, more AGESA stuff and more hardware support. And yeah, and finally we are in version 4. And evolving since 2012. Most important thing that kind of gave me a lot of thinking about coreboot was that Google decided to use coreboot as a Chromebook default BIOS. This was huge boost for coreboot project. Intel created a FSP. This was most probably because Google pushed Intel that they don't want to use this AMI inside Phoenix code, so they decide ask Intel to provide like smaller possible initialization code that could be integrated in coreboot. So at that point I worked in Intel, and it was like blasting information for me. Also the like couple additional things happened at that time. There was WikiLeaks Vault 7 publications, there was Snowden revelations, and many major security failures from big silicon vendors and IBVs. And probably because of that, coreboot was more and more and more popular. And right now, definitely we're going into stage of renaissance when major hardware vendors understand what coreboot is, what value it provides. So as you can see on this graphics, on coreboot website, you can find all the releases and the dates. Recently, 12 May, there was release of version 4.4.12. The cadence of coreboot release is 6 months, and yeah, of course we should expect in November another release.